Welcome, Randall and Scarlett here.
Yes, we are. We are here bringing another episode of some more info. And yeah, today's topic is really cool. We like this topic.
It's like turned into our like signature. Like if you have a signature move or a signature song, like today's topic is our like our basis.
It is. And what really everything, because we've been a blended family for really almost 15 years is what we're saying, because we're closer to that mark than any other. And we have learned so much through that process. Mm-hmm. And now we're on the other side where we're kind of tiptoeing into the other side of our kids are now turning into young adults and they're starting their own lives. We still got a few of them back in the house with us, so they kind of flown the coop and then have come back. So yes. You know, we kind of have that dynamic, but we have learned so much, because whenever we started, our kids were younger. So if you don't know that, our youngest was four, turning five, and our oldest was eight, turning nine at that time. And so we really had a tough time blending together. We had a tough time just step-parenting issues. Kind of one of the toughest roles in our family dynamics was the stepmom.
I mean, it wasn't always hard. I mean, we functioned as a family.
For sure. We had a lot of good times.
Yeah, but like when it came down to certain things, like actually blending and becoming one, like we lived in the same house,
there was still a lot of division.
Yeah.
So she would kind of parent one way with her biological kids. I would do the same thing with my biological child. And we just, it took us a while to figure out that unity and how to come together. And once, kind of through that process, there was drama and all kinds of things mixed in with all the good things. We had a lot of good moments too.
Which we find now is completely normal. But when you're in the middle of these kind of things and you feel like it's just you, it's just your family, everybody else got it together.
Yeah. So be encouraged. Blended families take time. I was reading the new book, Love Languages in a Blended Family. I forget the title of the book. But it's such a powerful book, and they kind of brought up the same thing that we have heard. You know, it does take a long time. You know, it's not a blended family isn't just a microwave recipe. We learned a long time ago that it's a crock pot recipe. They use the analogy of a slow cooker.
Cooker is a crock pot. Right?
Yeah.
It's like, yeah.
I was like, yeah, we've always called it like a crock pot. And she's like, that's the name brand.
Yeah, the crock pot is like the actual like Sprite, like Coca-Cola. I don't know.
But I think when you're in a blended family, especially the first few years, you're thinking, man, we're just going to come together and everything's going to be great. Our relationships are going to be healthy. And, you know, we're going to be the mom, the dad, or the, you know, the functioning parents. And it just doesn't work that way.
Especially when you're Christians and you're coming at it like with such a genuine heart. It's like it shouldn't be that hard, because we just love naturally and we just want to love this family. But sometimes not everybody in the family wants to be loved in that way.
Yeah, and so it takes a while. Average, we've always heard around 7 years, 5 to 7 years. Sometimes even longer.
Like 10 if you have like a lot of like different
dynamics and how much outside influence you have coming into it. So for us, we never had children on our own. It was just our own biological children coming together, and we blended our family that way. So, and then later on, we threw in another child who was 17 at the time, that brought her into our family dynamics. And, you know, that was a whole nother blended issue thing that we've been going through. And we're really just now kind of getting to where that's blending. And that
really
was about 5 years ago.
All of our relationships are finally coming to that place where it's like, okay, you know, like, okay, now it's functioning well, and now people don't hate each other or want to run or
hide.
A
lot of the walls have come down, and we just blended, we're seeing the blessings from the hard work.
Yes.
So just be encouraged in a blended family. It takes work. It is, and you know that if you're listening to this, it takes a lot of just intentionality with it. But out of
real quick, before we switch over, the book is called Building Love Together in a Blended Family.
Yeah, that's good. And one of the co-authors of that is the one who did The Five Love Languages.
Yeah, Gary Chapman. Yeah.
Powerful book. I just now really started getting into it. I'm like on chapter 4 right now as we're talking. So, but man, just mind-blowing. It's like, man, this is good stuff. So, we'll definitely share a lot of kind of, report on kind of that book as well, because just good information. So, every blended family needs. But everything that we learned, we took it down to three things. We sat there and every topic that we came up with, everything we said, man, is so important, because you got parenting styles, you've got co-parenting issues, you've got step-parenting dynamics, you've got...
Just fighting in the household, sibling rivalry.
No, learning how to parent as a step-parent, and just the different dynamics that come in. There's so much within blended families that whenever we really laid it all out and we talked and we walked through everything, we put out three key ingredients. So there's really three key ingredients every blended family needs. And this pours into just a normal dynamic family. But it's very important for blended families that we got to get these and we got to work on them to really, the more focus we put on these three, the quicker you're going to see the rewards in your family, the quicker you're going to see the unity, the more peace you'll find in your household. And that's ultimately what we all want, is to have that.
And I think in a blended family, you have to be just a little more conscious about it and intentional about it, because you do have that history of divorce. So sometimes that fear like haunts you and follows you in that aspect of like, okay, if this doesn't work, are we going to end up divorced? Or you have before you had the option of leaving, is someone going to leave? So that's always haunting you. So these ingredients that we're talking about today are so important, because when you're getting married for the first time and you fall in love and you're starting to have children together, there's just a different type of bond that's there with a little more security, I think. That's just, you come to expect it or just know that it's always going to be there. But once you've experienced that break and that brokenness, it messes you up in a way with them trust issues. Like, it can give you some trust issues all around everybody.
Well, and that's exactly it. You do. And whenever you're going into a new relationship, it's a lot easier for the husband and wife to build that trust a lot quicker than our kids. Our kids come in there with a defense already, because kind of like the book, they talk about insiders and outsiders. And that's kind of, ultimately how our kids see it. They see, hey, who are these new people coming into our life and our family dynamics? And they start seeing them as the enemy. And it's easier for them to start putting up walls. So there's challenges that we face just within that. And so that's kind of, as we were just really laying all this out and pouring into these three key ingredients, it's like, these are so powerful. This is like the core of family right here. This is the core of any family. This is the core of a blended family that you got to know, that you got to start really diving in and growing in these areas. So the first one that we're going to talk about is our mindset. Now, we've talked on mindset, if you've listened to us in any other platform or whatnot, we've talked on mindset before.
Yeah.
So mindset is so crucial.
Yeah, it really is, because if you are going into it with the mindset of divorce being an option, or the mindset of like, is this gonna work? Could this even work? My family's never going to make it. We're never gonna be like a normal family. If that's the stuff that's haunting your thoughts all the time, and those are the words that you're speaking out, then that's what comes to follow. Because, and we say this so often on here, we did a whole talk on mindset specifically, but what you look for, you're going to find it. So if you're looking for the negative, you're going to find the negative. If you're looking for positive, you're going to find the things to prove your point there.
And when you're entering into that marriage initially, you've got those endorphins, those hormones, or you know, all the chemicals kind of going on that you don't see that. You're just in love, and that's an awesome, that's a beautiful thing. And normally it's not until you start getting into it, maybe a year or 2 years in, and you start seeing some of these difficulties coming up, and you're like, man, I thought we were gonna blend together a lot faster, and you're not. And I think that's when those thoughts can easily start creeping in. They can start coming in on you. And what we've learned is that you've got to shift that focus. God says, you know, we always take it back to God's words, but God says in Proverbs 23:7 that as a man thinketh in his heart, therefore he is. So it's whatever we're thinking on, you know, it's like, is our family going to work? I don't see us having a relationship with our kids, you know, and you're starting to think this, you're going to start seeing more of that. You're going to start seeing the negativity. It's whenever we start shifting our focus and saying, what do we want our family to be? Where do we want our family to go? No, I'm not seeing it right now, but we're going to have good relationships. Our family is going to blend well. It's going to be hard, right? And no one says that this is easy, but you know, you start setting your focus on the goal and where you want to go and where you know you're going to be and you're going to achieve it. And then the second part of that, and well, let me stay on that for a minute, is that's not an easy task. Okay, I'm saying that it's not easy, that sometimes it's an everyday refocus, right? Sometimes it's an everyday, and I've had to do this with myself all the time, is our default is what we're seeing. Our default is it's not working. Our default is, man, there's so many walls up. My default is, you know, how are we ever going to get through this?
Or like by now, something should have changed by now. Like it's been 5 years, and you know, I thought it was going to get better. And when you're not seeing that, you can just start speaking those
It
things and thinking
comes
those.
in, and it's a daily thing. So it's a constant reminder of saying, no, God has put us together. God called our family together, or we wouldn't be together. And so it's knowing that, and then knowing that our God is for us and not against us. So He wants your family to work. He doesn't want you to end this blended family in a divorce. He doesn't want that for you. So when we know that we have a big God for us, that gives us that ammunition to say, no, our family is going to work. You know, and it's whenever we shift to that positivity and knowing that it's not easy, it's going to take work. I've got to keep taking myself, my thoughts back over here. There's just power whenever we do that, you'll start seeing more
Well,
positive
when you
things.
just learn that just because a thought pops in your head doesn't make it true.
Yeah.
Like a thought in your head is not a truth. It is just a thought. And sometimes the enemy is there to put those negative thoughts in our head and use those thoughts against us. So it pops up, and the Bible says that you can actually take that thought captive and decide, is this truth or is this a lie? And then you can, if it's truth, take it to the bank. If it's a lie, replace it with
Yeah.
something.
And I'm going to throw some scriptures out and stuff like that kind of through this talk. We're going to keep it you know, kind of short, of course. You know, we're not going to go super long, but you know, so don't get so caught up on the scriptures. We'll put those kind of in the notes and everything below. That way you can go look at them later and everything and really see what God calls for us, right? Because that ultimately, that's what kept us together, was God's words softening our hearts and kind of teaching us, giving us, you know, we've started finding other resources and things like that we really felt God pushing on us. So, you know, that's kind of what we're talking about today. But the second part of mindset is our speaking. Now, Proverbs 18:21 says that the words that we speak can bring life or they can bring death. And so really it's the two things. So if we bring that kind of down to what we're talking, what we're speaking in life, that means we're either building each other up or we're tearing each other down. And that can go the same for what I'm saying about myself and what I'm saying about my
Your
wife, my
spouse or with your
spouse, my
kids.
kids. And a lot of times I don't think I know we do it without even realizing we're doing it. And that's the thing, we just speak what we see. And a lot of times I'm never going to have a relationship with my kid or my stepkid, you know, or I'm always going to be fighting with my
Yeah, they're
ex-spouse.
always fighting.
Yeah, so it's the
They're never
things
gonna get along.
that we're saying. So we're thinking it and we're saying it, but there's power in even our words, that whenever we start saying, no, that's not what God says. God says our family is going to work. I'm going to have a good relationship with my kids. You know, and when I take it and I turn it around, I speak it, there's power in that that you're releasing over your family. So, you know, that's something that it took us a while to learn. And it's just one of those daily reminders that, you know, it's our thoughts and our speaking can create a world of difference in our family. So, you know, whenever I took the personal time to reflect on, you know, what am I really saying to my kids? You know, and I started becoming more mindful of what I was saying. Never, you know, I don't get it perfect by any means, you know, and I never claim to, but I would start being more aware if I said something negative that really is kind of, you know, tearing them down a little bit. I would capture that and I'd be like, oh man, I really blew that one. And then it makes me a little bit more intentional the next time that, you know, maybe I'm having a conversation or I'm going and apologizing, saying, you know, son, I shouldn't have said that. You know, that was wrong. And, you know, this is really, you know, what I believe, you know, where we're headed.
Yeah, and being able to humble yourself in that way. Because I know there's times where, like, when we started becoming very focused on this and trying to do better about the words that we speak, that you might, like, call me out on it. Not in front of the kids or anything, but, like, kind of like that little nudge and be like, ugh. And
it's a little nudge.
I'm like, what? And he would just remind me of just, like, well, the way that came across. And I was like, oh, I didn't mean for it to come across that way. Or, you know, and just recognizing, like, oh, okay, you know, and the next time when I do it, I'm more aware. And it takes a while. It takes a lot of practice to start changing the things that you're saying to them and not having to say everything that you see that's wrong with your kid, feeling like it's your job to have to point every one of those things out, but to actually be able to just keep your mouth shut and allow just sometimes natural consequences or life or them to figure it out on their own or ask more questions and not feel like you need to, like, point out everything that they're doing wrong.
So we say this knowing it's not easy, right? If it was easy, then every family would be awesome and we'd all think positive about everything.
Yeah.
But this takes a lot of work and most of the time we don't know it. Yeah. You know, we don't know. We act in the moment, we act on emotion, and we act without thinking about it. So whenever we recognize it, then we can start overcoming it, catching it, and saying, okay, now I can say better things. And sometimes it's coming up with default sayings that you practice over and over again. And it's like, no, my family's doing great. My family's going to be awesome. You know, or you know, I'm just kind of, you know, coming up with something. But it is kind of capturing maybe what you know you say a lot and saying, how could I say that in a positive way? And then kind of rehearsing it or writing it down that way. Whenever you do come into that moment, now you're training yourself to speak positive instead of speak negative. So those are just some powerful tips, but our mindset is crucial. And that's anything in life, because what you focus on is where you go.
We do go a lot deeper on this, like in another one of the podcasts. It's just strictly mindset. And then we also have this three-part series where we talk a lot deeper, because we could keep talking on this, but I think we do need to get to the other.
Okay, so that's the number one ingredient is your mindset. And then number two
is communication. Like, you cannot over communicate with each other and with your children. And we see so often when people are arguing or fighting, and even ourselves, like most of these things that we say, when we see, it's because it's something that we had to learn. We had to go through that. We're still learning and that we're still going through with each other and with our kids. But when we reach out to you guys and we hear some of the things that are going on, we see that a lot of it stems from a lack of communication and not really on anybody just totally like turning their back and not wanting to communicate with their spouse or with their kids, but just out of busyness in life, or maybe hidden emotion that you have, that fear that you have inside of you, that you're like, I'm afraid if I say this, then they'll leave, or I'm afraid if I say this, it's going to start a fight. And so we hold a lot of stuff in, or maybe you have a back history of it, somebody leaving, or it's starting a fight. So, or a lot of times it is just pure busyness. There's been so many times in our life where we have someone be like, well, didn't Scarlett tell you that? Or didn't Randall tell you? And be like,
no.
We haven't talked in 3 days because of all the things that we're doing with our kids and work and him being in school and all of that, you know, we're running hustle and bustle during the day. And then we come home, eat dinner, go to sleep. Sometimes one of us would stay up so much later because they were studying or doing something for work, and the other one would go to sleep. And then we wake up and do the whole thing again. And we haven't talked. And when you're not talking, just even about the simplest day-to-day things, your activities that the kids have going on, things that your family members have going on, when you don't talk about those things, then when it comes up, you feel like the other person is like shutting you out or not including you.
Hey B-Fam, Randall and Scarlett here. Blended families can be hard at times. There can be all kinds of obstacles that we face, even more than being in just a nuclear family or a family before there's divorce and step-parenting. These obstacles can make you feel like you're all alone at times, stealing away your hope, your happiness, and even leave you wondering if your family's going to make it through these challenges.
But there's one thing that we can be certain of, and that God is for you, and He wants your family not just getting by, but receiving all of His grace and blessings. Randall and I know the struggles all too well, and we have both learned so much from our blended family journey that God put it on our hearts to share it with you, everything that we've learned in almost 15 years.
Yeah, we've seen our family go through so much chaos, but came out on the other end with a strong marriage and strong relationships with all of our kids. So we've created this complete roadmap to navigate through blended family life. We've laid it all out in a video series called Overcoming Blended Family Issues. There's a lot of information we provide through our podcast and blogs with so much free information that we really want you to have. But for those who want the shortcut to have it all in one place, we put all this information in a complete roadmap that walks you through it step by step.
The awesome thing is that you can watch it from your own home. We give you valuable tools and information along with things that you can put into place to see more positive results in your family.
So if you're having a lot of blended family issues going on right now, or even want to grab all this information before you do, be sure to check out our video series, Overcoming Blended Family Issues. Or maybe you even know someone who could use this help. Pass it along. They'll thank you for it. The link to the video series is in this episode show notes below. Now, back to our episode. Well, and as blended families as well, you're taking two households that have not been together and you're coming together, and y'all have different dynamics, different ways that you have done things in the past. And sometimes you can harbor resentment. You can harbor, you're trying to protect your kids, and maybe you feel like there's some favorites being played over here, or, you know, and there's so many issues that can come up with the blended families, and it all comes from lack of communication. Us not talking about it, getting it on the table, and most of the time we don't know how to talk about it. We will let things bottle up in us so much that eventually it will come out, and it comes out as us fighting, because now we're accusing each other. And normally when it comes to accusation, the other side, process goes to defense. Mm-hmm. And so now you've got this butting of heads, and there's nothing healthy that comes from that either. So it's really learning how to have that healthy communication where you're talking about things, because what happens is when you don't talk, you start putting up these walls. This is not just with husband and wife, this is with our kids as well. The more you start opening up and learning to communicate with each other and getting it all out and talking through things just as normal human beings, right? And not making it a big drawn out fight or accusations, but this is how I feel, you know, when this happens, and, you know, how do you feel? And you're working together through these situations, saying, you know what, we came together for a reason. We love each other. We're on the same team. Because when we don't, we start feeling like there is this big wall of division between us being married or with our kids. Mm-hmm. And the Bible tells us in both Mark and in Matthew that a house divided will fall. A house divided cannot stand. And whenever we don't communicate, walls go up. The more we learn to communicate healthy, the more those walls will come down.
And like communicating healthy, like it's just even recognizing like what is your communication style? Like what is your, like when conflict arises, how do you prefer to solve it? And then recognizing that for yourself and recognizing it in your spouse, and then being respectful of that, and both being respectful, because if you're somebody that likes to take issues head on, but your spouse needs time to process and they need to like just get away for a minute and have time to think, but you're like, no, we're doing this now, like, just they're two different ways. Figuring that out, like, okay, what is the best way for us to come together
and
communicate this, and respecting that sometimes people do things differently than you do, and that's okay, but you have to find something that's going to work for you guys to be able to talk. And then again, with your kids too, because they're little human beings and they have the same thing. They like to handle things a certain way as well.
And they're going to have issues, some issues they don't even know they're having.
Yeah.
And that's the, because they're still mentally developing as well. And when you get into a blended family, they don't know how to think. They just know that someone else is taking the attention from my mom or from my dad. And now they're seeing that as competition, or they're seeing that as division, and that they're the enemy. And there can be a lot of different issues that whenever you sit there and you start learning to talk through those, you start seeing these walls coming down faster. It's not easy. None of this is easy, right? None of it's easy, and Jesus never said that it would be easy or that we won't go through problems. But the more that we recognize these and we learn to work on them and work on these areas, the better results you'll see, the more peace you'll see in your house, and the quicker you'll see each other blending together. So, you know, you're still going to have your things, and it's still going to take time, right? It's still a process. But these are just some things that are key ingredients that we got to work on, especially as a blended family, being a lot more intentional with them, which leads us to the third key ingredient.
Yes. Well, and I love the stair step of these three things too, because you may be doing this and you're like, yeah, I hear this. I'm the one here. I'm the one listening. I'm the one that shows up. I'm trying to do things different, but I'm the only person in my household that is. So I love that first we start with the mindset, and that is something that you have complete control over, that you can take those thoughts captive and you can replace them. And then it goes into communication, and that's something we're bringing you together, especially with your spouse first, and start talking and making it a point to communicate better with each other. And then if they don't want to communicate with you, praying about it first and asking God to help open up those lines of communication, and not coming at it in a way where, you know, you're in the wrong, you need to do this, but like, hey, this is what I'm feeling, do you mind, can we talk about this? But then it comes into the third part. Like, I feel like the first two is kind of like a real solemn, you know, talk, like dun dun dun, but the third part, the solution, the thing to come in and like change the atmosphere in your family and bring it to where you really want it, is that third key ingredient, which is being intentional and having fun being intentional, because we can take life so serious. And I say this all the time, that like being a mom was one of the most important jobs that I've had. I will say is the most important job that I've had. And you would probably say that as a dad as well.
Sure.
And I take that role so serious. Sometimes I took it so serious that I sucked the fun right out of it. And I love being intentional. It's one of my favorite topics. And I love planning outings and dates and family things, but sometimes I would make it like an extra, you know, a special event, and I would suck the fun out of the day-to-day life. And so we just want to talk to you just here briefly with this last key ingredient, is about being intentional and having fun doing that in your day-to-day life and in the big stuff.
Because whenever life gets whenever you start running out of time, you know, when you start getting busy, well, that's what I was going to say, when life starts getting really busy, that can be some of the first thing that goes, is you start losing that one-on-one, which then when you're not being intentional with each other, and that means we're talking, we're coming together, we're having fun together, or just going on a simple walk together, you know, you in that, now you're communicating, which is so beneficial, right? So they all kind of tie in and go hand in hand. But you start losing that. That's the first things that go, because you get so busy. You're running kids here, you're running kids there, or you're busy at work. Maybe you've got school going on. All different types of things can happen to pull you away from each other. And so you do have to be intentional, and you do have to plan it. You do have to sit here and say, okay, this week, I'm going to say, once a week, me and my spouse, we're going to go on a date. And maybe it's just a 10-minute walk around the block. You know, it's just, but you're being intentional in that and saying, you know what, we're going to spend time together. We're going to spend quality time together to where I'm not on my phone. I'm just focused on you. And you do the same with your kids. And the thing is what we try to do is we try to be efficient with our time and use what we're already doing. And then, but pulling our kids in, maybe it's cooking, right? You talk about cooking.
Yeah.
To where maybe you're cooking dinner. Maybe you pull one of your kids in with you to help you and say, hey, come help me do this. And then you're just talking and doing life together. And so, you know, it's finding things that you're already doing, but ways that you can be intentional with each other and really pouring into those relationships. But it reminds me, I was reading Ephesians chapters 5 and 6 and how God talks about the family dynamics. And he talks about how you're supposed to be devoted to your spouse. And that you're supposed to, you know, as men, we're supposed to love her so much as Christ loved the church, that he died for her, you know, and that I'm supposed to be there and be really serve her and be there. And same with the
wife.
Yeah,
for the wives, you know, to their husbands,
the
respecting
wives are supposed
them.
To be there for them and devote themselves to the husbands. And you know, it just shows this awesome, it paints this beautiful picture of, you know, each other being intentional with each other and just being there for each other. And then it goes on talking about the kids and saying, now you got to be there for your kids and you got to be you got to love them and be their counsel and teach them and things of that nature. And so, you know, I love that beautiful picture of we got to be intentional with each other. And unfortunately, that is one of the things that goes, you know, and we get so busy, we lose that. So,
or sometimes even just that fear of rejection, like when he was saying, asking your kids to cook, that's one of those things that, like, maybe I've asked them in the past and they said no, or asked them to the store, or asked them to this and they said no. But then you just quit and you're like, okay, I know, like, for our teenage son, when he first moved back in, and so he's transitioning into young adult at this point. And in the beginning, you know, I was very intentional about inviting him down for dinner, and then just life, you know, whatever, he wasn't home, this and that. And, you know, we had a conversation one time and he was like, you don't even invite me down to eat anymore. And I was like, oh, I just thought you didn't want to come down because you never come down anymore. But you feel like that they're going to reject you, so you don't want to put yourself out there, especially like with your stepchild, if you have been rejected in that way. But not giving up and keep on and finding things that interest them and reeling them in that way as a starter. And then maybe eventually you get to, you know, finding something mutual, but start on where they're at. We talk a lot about this. You're going to hear these three things. We talk so many different times, and sometimes it's like I get tired of, like, or I think you guys are going to get tired of, like, y'all already said this, but we learn through repetition, and we can't take all of these things in at once and put them all into practice at once. So, like, we talk about this now, and maybe your biggest struggle is mindset, or maybe it is that you and your spouse aren't connecting and communicating, or maybe y'all are rocking that, but it's that you are so busy, you're in that busy season of life. So each time that we talk about it, you can, like, pull that one thing, like, this is what I need to focus on right now. And then when it's time, that's the beauty of, like, these episodes that we have and stuff, when it's time to focus on that other thing, you can go back and listen to that.
Yeah. And so that's kind of the thing of the week. You know, maybe we encourage you to take this information, and with your own family, we have to do this all the time, right? Yeah. It's a constant, it's not a one and done. It's a constant reminder and constant work. So we're constantly reflecting back on these. And every topic that we talk about, every issue that we've seen in a blended family, that we hear other blended families say, man, this is my struggle. You know, it all comes down to either mindset, communication, or being intentional. It could fall into one of those categories. So that's the power of this, and just really starting to learn that aspect of it and saying, okay, what can we work on? So I encourage you this week to take each one of these and individually reflect. So maybe take it yourself and say, okay, mindset. You know, where am I at right now? How am I doing this that's really good? You know, what am I doing that's really good? Yeah. And then what are some areas that I can improve? And taking time to reflect. Maybe you journal or you write it down, and then you move on to communication. And it's saying, okay, well, with communication, what are some areas I'm doing really good in? What are some areas I could work on? And so you're self-reflecting on that, then being intentional. You know, same thing, same process. Here's what am I doing good at? And then what could I do better at? And if you want to take it the step further, then you and your spouse are doing this individually, and then y'all both come together and y'all talk about each one. And y'all start talking through this, and man, you'll start seeing blessings
yes.
from doing that. We've learned so much on how to communicate with each other, and we've worked on each other on personally our mindsets to where we're more accountable with each other, even on that, and being yeah. intentional. We still, you know, it's we do good and then we cannot, and then it's like, but we know, and we bring it back up, yeah, we got to do this and that, and they're, okay, yeah. So, you know, it's just, it's always a constant work in a family, but whenever you work on it, you see so much reward from it, and it gets so much easier as you do it. So,
and when you start letting these things out and y'all are talking and you're spending time together, it is so freeing to not feel like you're tense bottling up these emotions inside. So yeah. give it a try.
Now, if any of these have been powerful to you, if you've sitting here and you're like, oh man, this was good stuff, and maybe you want to go deeper into this, we do go deeper. We offer, we have a free, it's a three episode video series that is an hour long each, and we take each day, we talk on one of these, and we really go a little deeper on that, and we give some more resources and some more things for you.
Yeah, we have it set up to where if that's something you're interested in, that it'll email you one each day, so that way your mind can just focus on this, and then you go about your day, and you're, like we're saying, being intentional and thinking about your mindset and the words that you speak, and then the next day it'll send you the one on communication, and so you hear that and you spend the whole next day just really paying attention to trying to be intentional with that communication. And then the next day you'll get your being intentional video. So we put it out there, and then it's yours. You can go back and listen to it when you need to. And then you have the little worksheets that just help guide those questions and get you to think.
Gives you some things that you can do and apply in your own family and stuff. So really, we just put that out there to be a blessing. We believe in it so strong. Man, I wish we would have known that when we started, when we were even a year or two in. You know, if we had known that, man, the power in our family, you know, we could have parented differently. We could have been just our communication together would have been so drastically changed.
Yeah.
So,
and you don't know what you don't know until you know it, and then you can, when you know better, you can do better. And so that is our heart, is just to share that with you, so that when once you start hearing it over and over and you start making these little changes, and man, when you start to see God's blessings in your family, when you start to see that switch from like, okay, what is happening here? Did I make a mistake, or is this ever gonna work? To watching your kids having these conversations with each other, starting to call each other brother and sister when they're step siblings. Your stepchild starting to call you mom, or them calling dad. Like
I had like tears.
Yes.
It's like, oh my God, all the work paid off. You know, so it's so much rewarding. It is. And God wants that for you. He's called you for it. So we just got to be intentional. We got to work on these things. And man, you're going to see it in your family. So the awesome stuff. We'll put the link to that if that's what you want, if you want to dive further. Like we said, it's free for you, so we'll put that in there. That way you can go check that out if you want to.
And but, I never like for us to leave without praying.
There you
so
go.
I'm going to pray over your family and just take this in and just know that each time we lift this up and we have God as the one that we do our part, but then we let God do his part, just trusting that he is coming through even when you can't see it. So let us pray now. Yeah. Father God, I just thank you right now that these key ingredients that you place on our heart, as we begin to speak on these and think on these and focus on these in our family, that you are doing a good work in their household. Father, that their mind is beginning to change, that they're learning to take their thoughts captive, Lord, that they're learning to communicate with their spouse in a way that they never have before. They're seeing the importance of it, and they're making time for it. They're prioritizing it. And Lord, things that they may have kept to themselves in the past, that now they're able to express themselves, and they're being heard and accepted. If there's any person in their family that just has these walls that are built up, Lord, I just pray right now in the name of Jesus that you are breaking them down, that only you have the power to do that, that you're softening their hearts, and they're beginning to see each other in a new light. And Lord, that they begin to be intentional and have fun doing that with their family, that busy is no longer a word that is getting in the way of them having that closeness and that relationship relationship with each other. As a married couple, that they're being intentional in their relationship. And then for the parent with their biological children, being very intentional so that their child doesn't feel like the step family is coming in and taking that attention away, taking that relationship away, and putting a wedge in between. So they're very intentional with that biological child's relationship, but then also they're beginning to build a bridge, a relationship with their stepchild, where they're getting new creative ways to reach out to them, and that both of their hearts are softened and seeing each other in a new light. And Lord, that they're being just gentle in that relationship and knowing that there are some trust issues, Lord, but that you can make it work, Lord, that you're the one that comes in and that you can mend that relationship. You can bring it close together, even when it takes time, Lord, that you are working. And I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Good stuff. So love you guys. We will, like I said, we'll put that in the link, but also the scriptures. I'll just put the scriptures down there too. That way that you have them, maybe you're taking those throughout the week and just kind of going back to the Bible and saying what God said, you know, seeing what he says on that and letting him minister to you through that.
So. Take my thing. Take one scripture and write it huge on your mirror in a dry erase marker. Write it somewhere where you can see it all the time. And then as soon as that negative thought comes in, you just like, nope,
not today.
Not today, Satan. This is what God says.
That's right. Powerful stuff. Yeah. So awesome. Love you guys. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you on the next episode.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Hey, thanks for joining us today for another episode of Enjoying Your Blended Family. All the links we've talked about today, they're in the show notes below. If you've enjoyed listening, be sure to subscribe below. It's free and it lets you know when we have another episode for you to listen to.
And if you want to help us out, leave us a rating and review so that we can keep reaching more people. Until next time, remember to enjoy the moment.